Hello, I'm District 3 Commissioner Tarinia Carthen, and welcome to my first District Dialogue. You will be watching this air in February, which is, of course, Valentine's Month, Black History Month, but I would like to call it Love Month. And one of the things that is near and dear to my heart is the Senior Services Department, which you will get a chance to hear about shortly from my guests. So since it is near and dear to my heart, I will start with the Director of the Senior Services Department, and that is Director Hagan.
Well, thank you, Commissioner.
Thank you for joining me.
It's a joy to be here and appreciate this opportunity to get the word out about what we do.
Yes. And who do we have joining us today?
Well, we have Stephanie Pans, who is our volunteer coordinator. We have Heather Nutter, our social services director. And we have Kim Smallwood, our senior center manager.
Hi, Kim.
Hi.
Well, thank you, ladies.
Hi.
Thank you.
Tell me a little bit about the Senior Services Department. Like, I could go on and on and on, but I want them to get the official of what the Senior Services Department.
The official statement. Well, we have been in service to the community since 1974. Mm-hmm. We have a mission of enhancing the quality of life and promoting the independence of our older adults in the county. Mm-hmm. Our services range from the one you're most intimately familiar with, and I would think that the community is as well, would be the Meals on Wheels program. But we also offer congregate meals, we offer transportation, we offer in-home services that Heather supervises, such as homemaker services, case management services, and information and assistance that we provide to the general public.
Wow. So the Senior Services Division does a lot more than just Meals on Wheels.
We do a lot more than just Meals on Wheels.
Yeah, I was introduced to you through Meals on Wheels, which I absolutely love, and I started doing in 2009. Mm-hmm. And just a brief backstory, I actually did Meals on Wheels when my husband and I lived in Hawaii, and he was stationed at Pearl Harbor. That was my way to get to know the island and the people and my surroundings, so I volunteered. And it just, it really stuck with me. So when we came back home, I kind of dibbled and dabbled and saw what I wanted to do. And I came right back to Senior Services Meals on Wheels right here in Douglas County. And I have enjoyed it tremendously. Week in and week out, I look forward to seeing my seniors, you know, and some of which they just become family. And so it's hard to not do it. So just as a volunteer, I would start at one day, 1 hour on my lunch break. And from there, it's turned into almost 10 years. And the amount of satisfaction that I get, I just wanted to share it with others. So I'm so glad you guys are there. Just as much as, you know, you do for the community, you really do it for me. And I'm pretty sure most of the volunteers would say the same thing.
I think Steph could probably elaborate more, but I think that's a very common thing that we hear is that people start off thinking that, you know, it's just the service they're providing, but then they realize how much more they get out of it.
So, Stephanie, I have enjoyed getting to know you over the last 10 years. Every time I come into the Senior Services Department, it is so organized. All the meals are right there, our routes are right there. You make sure we have what we need. Even if it's raining, you'll say, hey, do you need me to help you? You just make sure that everything that we, the volunteers, need, we have. So tell me a little bit about how that all came about for you and your workings with the Senior Department.
Well, actually, I started out volunteering. And it was like in 2001 when I started. And then about a year later, I started working at the center, helping get the meals out, and then just a couple of hours, and then it turned into now 8 hours, and now I'm the acting volunteer coordinator.
So there's something about the love of just starting out as a volunteer, and it carries over, and before you know it, you are consumed by what it is, the senior services.
I love it.
And
yes,
you do. You just fall in love with it.
Yeah.
Wow, thanks. So Heather.
Yes.
This is my first time meeting you, but if you're part of this family, you're part of my family.
So. Well, I'm glad to be part of that.
So tell me a little bit about what you do at the Senior
services? Absolutely. So I supervise the in-home services and the mm-hmm. case management. So we have two case managers who help seniors and their families to find services in the community, services mm-hmm. we provide, but also services that are just available in the community. So we have the in-home services, the case managers. We do ourselves Homemaker, which is light housekeeping for seniors to help them to stay in their homes for as long as possible and to be as independent as possible. And so I just manage that and make sure that we are providing the services in a way that meets our funders' requirements, but also that helps to serve the clients to the best of our ability.
It's really important because I know with my grandmother, she's 91, mm-hmm. and if any of you got a chance to see the swearing-in ceremony, you saw my grandmother, who still drives. She still has her Cadillac mm-hmm. in the driveway. Mm-hmm. She doesn't drive as much, but if somebody is there late to pick her up, she will get in her own car and she will go herself, right? But that independence is so important, and that's one of the things that she stressed, you know, to her children, her grandchildren, having that independence, living on her own, being able to transport herself where she needs mm-hmm. to go, not to be, I guess you can say, a burden or mm-hmm. bothersome mm-hmm. on somebody. And then yeah. you have to think about, a lot of times now, we're scattered.
Yes.
Yeah, so family mm-hmm. is not as close to you as, you know, back in the day. Mm-hmm. And so just to be able to have you guys there and coordinate those services so that people can stay in their homes and really feel like, you know, I've done it, I've made it, I'm able to raise my kids and now still be able to be independent. So
absolutely. Yeah. We have a lot of clients who are born and raised here in the community, mm-hmm. but then we have a lot of folks who've come down to join their children, mm-hmm. their grandchildren, and then for some reason that child might get transferred to another state, and then they're left here in a community that they've grown to love, mm-hmm. and they want to stay, and so we do our best to make that possible for them.
That's awesome. Oh my gosh. So now my friend on the end, Kim. Kim, I feel like we've known each other forever.
Right.
It has. You talked me through graduations and my daughter getting married.
Right.
And yes, and me becoming commissioner. You was like, are you sure you want to do that?
You remember that conversation? I remember that conversation. And are you glad you did?
I am glad I did. All and right. I'm glad you are here to share this with me.
Well,
really.
I'm glad to be here. And
so
support you.
Thank you. Yes. I appreciate that. So can you tell us a little bit about what you do?
Right. Well, I manage the senior center, so I oversee the congregate meals mm-hmm. and the preparation for the home-delivered meals as well. The services or the activities that the seniors do when they come into the center, I oversee that as well, plus transportation to and from the center, mm-hmm. as well as the medical transportation that we provide.
Oh, wow.
Right.
So I didn't even know you guys did medical transportation. Okay, so... Yes. Coming back to you, Richard, what all services, you know,
well, let me touch on
staff
that.
Members?
Well, let me touch on that okay. a little bit if I can, because as you know, mm-hmm. during your campaign and just looking at one of the hot buttons in the community in the last year or so has been the implementation of a transit system.
That's true.
But we're excited about about that, but also about the fact that we have such a wonderful partnership mm-hmm. with our transit services mm-hmm. division. Because I think a lot of people, you know, it's a classic case of you may not know about a service in a community until you need it.
Until you need it.
And then that's when you go into research mode, or maybe one of your children does, or a family member. But I think that's the thing one of the things that we're very excited about is mm-hmm. the development of that. Mm-hmm. And also just continuing to enhance the transportation services mm-hmm. In the county. We, as Kim says, she supervises the non-emergency medical transportation, as well as the other drivers that transport seniors to and from the senior center. And so we're fortunate this year, mm-hmm. we've added another full-time position mm-hmm. to be able to provide that non-emergency medical transportation. So we're very excited about that.
Wow. That's awesome. It is, because that also means that the population is there and we needed to provide for them, and we were able to. So that's a testament to how you're running that department and that division, that you're able to make sure that the budget is there and that we can do that for
us. Well, I think it's a partnership.
It is.
I think that the Board of Commissioners, the County Administrator, mm-hmm. It's a great partnership mm-hmm. that they just provide, looking out for the citizens of our community mm-hmm. and working together to provide those services.
Yes, because eventually we will all be there, right?
We hope we'll all be there.
We would want those services if we needed them.
Exactly.
So, yeah. Okay. So now how many staff are under your department?
We've got a total of 31. We have 20 full-time positions mm-hmm. and 11 part-time okay. positions. Now, four of those would be at the Woody Fight Center.
Oh, okay.
So there would be a total of 27 that would be directly involved with the human services aspect. There's a little mm-hmm. bit, if I can, make a little distinction mm-hmm. between the Woody Fight Center mm-hmm. and the center that Kim manages. Is, I guess that distinction would be that Kim's center has a little bit more of a social services mm-hmm. Focus mm-hmm. to it.
Okay.
I mean, obviously a lot of the people that come to the Senior Center on Fairburn Road are mm-hmm. very active.
Yes.
Including some, I think, that are over 100, right, Kim?
Right. We actually have yeah. a client who's 100. She'll be 101 in March.
Oh,
and we have
beautiful.
A client who's 99 who will be 100 in June.
Oh, wow.
And she's quicker than we are.
Oh, wow.
Yes.
Wow. So that's a testament to, you know, the activities that you guys are providing that would make them want to come
right.
and be a part of it.
Right.
That's awesome. So sure. now, how many volunteers do you have?
Stephanie, I will defer to you on that okay. question.
Okay. We have around 70 volunteers.
Wow.
Even though that seems like a lot, mm-hmm. we still need volunteers.
Mm-hmm. For the route that I'm on, I don't think I have any subs. Do I? I think one sub.
Okay. That may be able to fill in sometimes,
but not on a regular basis.
No, not on
right,
a regular basis.
Right, right. Which is one of the things that, you know, one of the reasons why I'm doing this segment, because I believe mm-hmm. everybody can give at least 1 hour.
Yeah, 1 hour.
1 hour, even if they do it, you know, once every quarter, or if they commit to 3 times out of a year to be on the list, to
right.
get
yes,
trained, just
help.
To volunteer. It would help tremendously. Yeah, and yes. they'll end up like me, looking for another route to do, because you do, you
right.
enjoy it.
And
you
I
know,
have to
so
call
much.
On you, mm-hmm. you know, other than the day that you volunteer,
yes.
because we don't have enough volunteers.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And
so we're hoping to change that. We're
yes.
hoping when people see this district dialogue, they will call up Senior Services, ask for Stephanie, and get put on the list to be added. Because
yes,
there are
a lot
of areas that, you know, they could definitely need you in. Besides drivers, where else would you need volunteers?
Well, that's
the main one.
The main one.
Okay.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Gotcha.
For me. Yes.
Well, Douglas County has a lot of employees with a lot of, I would say, more than 30 minutes for a lunch break. So hopefully they will consider, you know, coming around the corner and volunteering on their lunch break.
Yeah. I saw where Greystone recently implemented, or they're in the process of implementing mm-hmm. a program like you're talking about, where they're going to, trying to remember, give 8 hours a month maybe for volunteerism
oh, wow.
or whatever. So yeah, that may be something that would be worth looking mm-hmm. into, about some type of county volunteerism program.
Yeah.
On a match basis or whatever, but mm-hmm. just some type of incentive mm-hmm. to county staff to do that.
Yes, yes. And I think just doing that, it would enlighten them mm-hmm. as to most of them, those who work here, to see where their tax dollars are
sure.
going and how, you know,
sure.
we are really utilizing them in the best light if mm-hmm. they come on board. Because if you don't have volunteers, then that means you have to pay, or you have to take somebody from another department
right.
to do something, and
right.
then that
right.
you know, impedes you from
right.
doing other things that need
right.
to be done.
Yes,
so
yes,
yeah, so we want volunteers.
Yes.
So can you talk to me more about the home delivered meals and the what goes into that, and how someone would, you know, get on that program?
Absolutely. So the home delivered meal and the congregate meal are actually the same meal that are made each day, Monday through Friday.
Mm-hmm.
And so what we do is we have volunteers and staff who will, well, I guess it's staff who packs the
mm-hmm.
meals.
Yes.
And then
mm-hmm.
the volunteers will come in and they'll deliver the meals for us.
Mm-hmm.
So the way that we have clients to get onto that, into the program, the home delivered meals program, is that they go through a screening process. They call the Atlanta Regional Commission and they do the screening process for us. They ask the clients about their needs. They mm-hmm. do use three screening tools. One is called the Determination of Need.
Mm-hmm.
The second is the Food Security Survey. And then the third is the Nutrition Screening Instrument. And so it just gets a basic, broad understanding of the need that the client has. And then once they get that information, they send it to us in our computer system.
Mm-hmm.
They get put automatically on our waiting list, and our case managers will go in and they will look at the needs of the clients, and we go in and we do a home assessment, because sometimes we know that what's reported over the phone may not be exactly what's mm-hmm. what the actual case is. Mm-hmm. So they go in and they do a home assessment mm-hmm. and use the same screening tools, but they just do it in person so that we get a better understanding. And then they're also able to determine whether or not our services are appropriate, because okay. some clients may need a higher level of care than we're able to provide, or mm-hmm. that is appropriate for us to provide, because some individuals need a little extra help. Mm-hmm. So they're able to connect them with those resources, and then any other resources that they might not have shared over the phone through the initial screening process.
Okay, so once you get their name mm-hmm. and their information, you send someone out just to verify that and see what else may be provided?
Exactly.
What needs mm-hmm. to be provided. Mm-hmm. Gotcha. So now, do you work in conjunction with other resources and programs within the county that
Absolutely.
Don't fall under senior mm-hmm. services?
Absolutely. We have several. Kim is our case manager who does information referrals. She's also our information referral specialist. Mm-hmm. And so she and the other case manager that work are intimately acquainted with the other resources in the community. Mm-hmm. So we'll often refer them for whether it's food pantries.
Okay.
We may assist with SNAP, which is mm-hmm. a food benefit for clients. Mm-hmm. Maybe sometimes medical benefits. We often will connect folks for dental help. Mm-hmm. Anything that they're in need of that we can try to find those resources and connect them with. Mm-hmm. Now, we don't do everything for them, because mm-hmm. we're trying to promote their independence. She
right.
will often provide them with that information and then follow up with them to make sure that those needs have been met.
Got you. So Kim, in your capacity as the resource person for that, has there
different Kim.
different Kim,
yeah.
I was going to say that.
She's our case manager. She's one of our case managers. Okay. I apologize, that wasn't clear. She's one of our case managers.
I think if we added that to Kim's responsibilities, I might get
it.
Oh, goodness. But that's okay. The fact that you all have, it seems like, every facet of someone working to ensure that our seniors are taken care of is phenomenal. Mm-hmm. Even in a county this size, you know, we're growing by leaps and bounds. Mm-hmm. And yes. I know when I came here 19 years ago, I used to could go to the mall and Quick Trip and all that in no time. And now it's like,
it's a process.
It's a process. Yeah. And so yeah. I can just imagine, you know, trying to make sure that you have enough resources in place. Because when people call you, and especially when they're seniors, your heart goes out to them immediately, because you know that if they could, they get out the bed and cook for themselves or mm-hmm. or clean up or do
sure.
whatever. Mm-hmm. But the fact that they're reaching out means that they need you, and they need you now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So I'm impressed by this.
I will say, in conjunction with what Heather said, we do have seniors who come to the center as well, and mm-hmm. We provide mm-hmm. transportation for them to come as well okay. as, it's probably about half and half that drive as well,
uh-huh.
and we also provide resources for them mm-hmm. In the same manner.
So tell me some of the activities.
Uh-huh. Well, we have a wellness coordinator who okay. she does medical information. Mm-hmm. She coordinates with other resources in the county. WellStar is one of them, Kindred Hospice, mm-hmm. and she gets them to come in and do presentations on different medical issues,
okay.
Disease processes, mm-hmm. As well as she does a nutrition topic once a month herself.
Okay.
We have trips that we take once a month. We have a small exercise room. We have a pool mm-hmm. table where we're actually starting to get a lot of men. Yes, they love to come in. We've been predominantly women for a long time, but uh-huh. we are getting more men, and that's uh-huh. that's pretty awesome.
That is.
Yeah, because men don't really want to come out that way, but mm-hmm. but the women do, so
mm-hmm.
but yeah, we have a lot of activities mm-hmm. Monday through Friday, from about 10:30 till about noon.
Mm-hmm. And I think one of the cutest ones that I've seen is when Chick-fil-A does the cow day.
And we used to do that. We used to dress up like cows, all of us, the seniors,
and everybody,
right.
So it's and it's that type of interaction too that keeps the mind healthy,
right. mm-hmm.
that allows you to, you know, get new friendships, you know, and just you have you continue to have your friends in your life, and which continues to add vibrancy to you still being independent and still wanting to remain independent
right.
as a senior.
I will say that's one of the reasons why the volunteers are so important for mm-hmm. us, is our clients, unlike Kim's, they're not able to get out as much.
Mm-hmm.
So those recipients of the home-delivered meals really count on those volunteers to be that bright spot mm-hmm. in the day. And the volunteers are the ones coming back to us and letting us know how that individual is doing. Mm-hmm. If anything's changed that we need to be aware of, they're really our eyes and ears mm-hmm. on the ground. And mm-hmm. so it's really vital for us to have that relationship with the volunteers. And when there is something wrong with one of their seniors, they let us know.
Yes, they let us know. We do. I know I do.
Yes. Yeah. And so it's invaluable to us as mm-hmm. staff to have that connection and to have the volunteers going in and doing that, because the seniors really do love it.
I don't know, we love it. I get so many compliments, and if I don't have on like my heels, because I'm so used to wearing heels, but if it's on a day where I've been running and I don't have on heels, a couple of them will say, so are we giving up the heels? they start to notice things about you.
Yeah.
Right. So they keep me on my toes. And to your point, yeah, there was a client not too long ago that she just seemed downed when I came in. I would try to talk to her and she was just kind of, you know, aloof. And I finally asked her, I was like, what's going on? You're not talking as much. And she says, my daughter died and she's in Florida. And so I came and reported to Kim. I was like, you know, this senior, she's having a rough time. Mm-hmm. And so it's those things you do, you notice it. And so you want to be there to help. And so reporting it to you all allows them to get that help that they need. So mm-hmm. It is. It's just it's a great program, a phenomenal program. I just can't see why anybody wouldn't volunteer to come and be a part of it. And like I said, everything is so organized. I mean, from the time I've started with you guys, it has just been nothing but truly a blessing. It really, really has. Even for me, you know, I think about, you know, as I'm aging, you know, mm-hmm. I would want someone, you know, if I couldn't do certain things,
right.
to come and help. Even if it's just 10 minutes, I try to stay, you know, so that I don't go past my lunch hour,
right.
you know, but just to talk, because sometimes people don't have mm-hmm. a day-to-day interaction with people.
Right, they don't.
You know, somebody may call on the phone, but what if you don't get that phone call that day?
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So just to have that, you know, one-on-one interaction mm-hmm. for just a few moments.
Mm-hmm.
And quick story, one of my seniors, he's no longer my route, he's I'll say his name, Mr. Bragg. Do you remember Mr. Bragg? Mm-hmm. Mr. Bragg didn't have any legs. One day I walked in to deliver his meal and he was up on the stool changing a light bulb. And I said, Mr. Bragg, why didn't you wait? You knew I was coming. He said, kiddo, why would I wait for you to do something I can do? You know, but I was just standing there like in amazement. And so, you know, I thought about, wow, so if he can do that, that just gave me such encouragement and hope that he didn't wait for somebody to get there to do it. He thought, I can do it myself,
do it.
And
mm-hmm.
he did.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
And that blessed me.
Yes.
So there is no excuse for you to say, well, you cannot do it. Mr. Bragg, who only, you know, who's amputated below the knee, could get up on, you know, on the ladder and change a light bulb. So can you.
Sure.
So those are the types of stories that, you know, mm-hmm. keep me going and you know, that makes me say I got to do this. Even if, you know, my schedule is a little off, and it has been with me running
yeah.
and training and things of yeah. that nature, still, when I get the moment, yes, I'm there. So, again, thank you. So is there anything else you want to add?
I don't think
any aspect of services that we've missed that the public should know about?
I know the Woody Fight Center always has something going on, because I always hear about, you know, the many services that they have going on. I know Chairman Jones just talked about the birthday party that went on that she mm-hmm. that you guys did, or Christmas party last year, mm-hmm. or so that's
I think we have both, Woody Fight and our center both did a Christmas party, but uh-huh. she came to ours she was there for probably about an hour.
Uh-huh.
Yeah,
uh-huh.
Just
having fun,
interacting, uh-huh. and yeah, dancing with the clients.
See?
So yeah. they were posing for pictures. They were having a great time.
See? That's amazing.
Right.
Just to be able to get outside your house and hang with your elected officials and other people, and just to have that fun. That's awesome.
Right.
So kudos to you guys for the program that you run and what you do for our seniors, you know, our seasoned saints is what we call them at church. But for what you do in Douglas County, we are so blessed to have you guys.
Well, I just want to add to that I feel blessed to mm-hmm. have such a staff such as this, and mm-hmm. these three, but then certainly the others, mm-hmm. many more that are dedicated to improving the lives of
like
seniors.
Like my Terry.
I like Terry.
Yeah, he isn't here, but he's the one who trained me. So hi, Terry, if you're looking at this, I mentioned you. Yeah, but all of the staff there, the cooks, everybody is just so amazing. And yeah, it's great. It's great. Mm-hmm. So Heather, you have anything to add?
I would just say that the way to become a volunteer, if someone is interested in volunteering, they can call us at 770-489-3100 is our main line.
Mm-hmm. One more time.
770-489-3100. That's our main line. And you would ask for Stephanie. She's the volunteer coordinator. You'd come in and fill out a volunteer application. It's a standard application that anyone that volunteers with the county fills out. Mm-hmm. It has a basic background check that they'll have to undergo, and they'll do a little interview with Stephanie. And then once they pass that background check, we do have a federal background check that we're required to have volunteers go through. Mm-hmm. Just, we want to make sure that our seniors are as safe as possible.
Mm-hmm. Of course.
And our volunteers, I will say that was a new process that we've just implemented, and our volunteers have been fantastic.
The response
that they have had to that request by us, or need, actually. It's not even a request, it's a requirement. Mm-hmm. They've been fantastic. But again, it's something that we've been asked to do by the state and the federal government, and they've been great. So, you know, volunteers just do those two, I would say, fairly easy steps. And then they work with Stephanie on when they can be scheduled for when they can do it, how often they can. We do have volunteers that are once a month. We have those who are once, or if not more than that, a week.
Once a week, yes.
And so we appreciate any assistance that the volunteers are able to give us.
Well, I'm just believing and hoping that this love month, we're going to get a lot of love at the Senior Services Department. I have a lot of volunteers showing up to help our seniors. So thank you guys so much for coming
in. Thank you for volunteering.
Yes. And making this my first District Dialogue an easy one.
We're honored.
Yes, very honored.
Well, thank you, Director Hagan, Stephanie, Heather, and Kim, for joining me on this District Dialogue. I really appreciate all that you do, and I know this will help us to get more volunteers. Thank you for joining me in District Dialogue. Tarinia Carthen, until the next time, have a great February. Hi, so today is Friday, and it is my Meals on Wheels day. I've been a Meals on Wheels volunteer with the Douglas County Senior Services Division since about 2009. And I have absolutely loved it. And so since becoming the new commissioner, I decided, you know, I don't think I'll give this up. I've been doing this long enough now that it's just a part of who I am. And so what I want to do is take you along on a journey with me to a couple of the seniors that I service on Fridays. So if you're ready, let's go. All right, family, this is one of my clients. This is the incomparable Mr. Pounds. He is a gentle teddy bear. And I've been servicing him now, I guess about 3 or 4 years you've been on my route. And he helped me with my campaign. He allowed me to put my signs in his yard. So, Mr. Pounds, tell me, why do you like Meals on Wheels? And why do you continue to let us service you?
Well, for one thing, I enjoy the food. And enjoy your company when you come.
Thank you.
And I also hope y'all continue to do this, and I'm glad that you won your place up there in the office.
Well, I thank you so much for helping me, and I'm going to continue to service y'all because I just like being in my community. It's just what you're supposed to do. So until next time, thank you, Mr. Pan. So we are back. This is one of my favorite volunteers. It is Mr. Terry. He was one of the first people I met when I started doing this back in 2009. So say hello to the people, Terry.
Hello, everyone. Glad to see you.
Terry, how long have you been a volunteer here at the Senior
Services? Well, actually, I'm a worker.
Now you're a worker.
Yeah, okay. I've been working for 8 years.
8 years of the 10? That's awesome. Actually, Terry trained me, so that's how I got to be as good as I am, because
exactly.
I learned from the best.
She's super.
Hi there.
You don't need to teach me that.
Okay. Yeah. And so here's one of my other good friends.
That's true.
I'm not.
Please. He's great, y'all. He helps me to the car with my bags. He is one of my main cheerleaders running for commissioner. He would
and when
me.
She and when she ran, I told her she was going to win.
He did.
And she won.
And I did.
And I'm going to support her 100%.
Thank you.
Whatever she needs, I'm going to do for the county. This is Commissioner District 3. She's the best.
Thank you. And I did not pay him, but I will give you a check afterwards. So being at the Senior Services Department is like a family. So I want to inspire you to volunteer. That's what we need here in Douglas County, more volunteers.
Absolutely.
All right.
Absolutely.
So the Senior Services Department delivers more than just meals on wheels.
Well, they have a homemaking.
They actually provide other services for Miss Darlene. So I just wanted you to meet one of my awesome seniors. I enjoy talking to her. I've learned so much from her over the years, and this is why I continue to do this. So thank you, and I'm signing off.